time with providers is very limited. All of us are on rigorous schedules at times, not because we're trying to see tons and tons of patients, it's just that we really don't know what one patient's time requirements are for the next one. So that makes it challenging for us to schedule. But I think it's important to understand that when you have the provider in the room, that's your opportunity to really utilize that provider and get full attention from that person. It's really important to run through your concerns that you have in your brain and your head before you actually come to the doctor, actually maybe even practice a little bit. I encourage patients to bring a list, but you need to prioritize that list. And that can include when it started, how it started, what things make it better, what things make it worse, and also bring a list of all their medications that they're currently taking, as well as any of the herbals or the over-the-counter medications that they're taking. And I think it's important to bring a list of medicines that they've tried in the past that were very effective, or those that they took in the past that were not effective. Bring in insurance cards. That's important. There's nothing worse than coming without their insurance cards. I think you should ask the doctor more about the diagnosis, understand that disease state, and not just how to pronounce it or how to spell it, but what it really means and what can you do to actually not only use medications to get yourself feeling better, but also what lifestyle changes can you make? Physical concerns and mental concerns really, I think, are right with each other. And I don't believe it's the patient's responsibility to know what causes what. I think it's important for them to bring all these things to us and lay them on the table again and say, let's figure out what's causing what. See if we can, maybe by fixing your physical symptoms, you're actually feeling better and you can actually sleep better and you're not as depressed and anxious and worried about things. Yeah, so if a patient leaves and they feel like they didn't have all their questions answered, or they leave and they have more questions that popped up from those questions that got answered, they should definitely follow up either with a phone call to the nurse, or perhaps more importantly, ask to schedule a follow-up appointment. It could be 10 o'clock at night and you're like, I just have this question and I just don't want to forget about it. Well, get on the MyChart and log that question, send it. It gets you sometimes direct contact with the physician again. We'll get messages from patients. Many times if the nurses will field those questions, and if they can't answer them, they'll forward them on to the physician and we'll respond back to that. And not only for you, but if you're, for instance, you have a concern about one of your children and you also have access to their chart, that's an excellent way to take care of multiple situations and multiple questions that you may have. Because us physicians, most of us really try and put the puzzle pieces together. And if you have all those puzzle pieces, you can lay them out for us and we can say, all right, let's work on this together and let's figure out if we can get you feeling better. And most physicians are very accommodating with that. That's what we do. We want to treat patients.